Hi guys, welcome to nvnark. Today I'm going to share how to make YouTube thumbnail for your video using free online design tools. My good friend, before continue, I would really appreciate if you give support by like and subscribe to my channel. Thanks. The tools we are going to use is photopea.com. First step, we will make the PNG file. First, create new file that has 1920 by 1080 pixel. With your image open, right-click your background layer, and click Duplicate Layer. Click the eye icon to the left of the original layer to turn that layer off. Select the Background Eraser tool from the toolbox on the left-hand side. Three dot in the tool options bar at the top of the screen, click the brush icon to reveal the brush panel. And the size can be whatever you deem appropriate for the image you're working with. In this case, I'm starting with 50px. You can adjust it as we go by using the square brackets, and to decrease and increase the size of the brush. Four dots still on the tool options bar at the top, set the mode to be continuous, and the tolerance to be somewhere in the range of 10-20%. Note that the lower the tolerance, the fewer color variations it will pick up. Conversely, the higher the tolerance, the more colors the tool will select. 5 dots, start erasing the background around your subject using the background eraser tool by clicking and holding while moving the brush. The goal here is to keep the crosshairs inside the tool from touching your subject. Zoom in on the image if you need to see more close details. By hold Ctrl plus scroll up, remembering to let go of the mouse from time to time, so that you can always undo if the brush goes too far. In the more difficult areas, you may find that you need to adjust the size of your brush as you go. You can do this by revisiting the tools option bar at the top. If resizing the brush doesn't work and it's erasing your subject, first undo your action. Now clean the noise using eraser tool if you need. Alright, now we have the PNG file that we are gonna use it to the thumbnail design. Save it, go to file, export as, PNG and save. Okay, now we have two layer. The original layer, in this case I call it layer 2, and we will make it as background. First, hide the layer 1, because we will manage the layer 2. Click on the layer 2, go to filter, drop down on blur, choose Gaussian blur. I like to pick the radiuses around 50-70px, then click OK. Still on layer 2, I want to change the color of the background. Go to image, adjustments, hue saturation. Check the colorize at the bottom left. Add some saturation, and change the hue as you like. I picked the green color here. Look nice. Then click OK. Now, open the layer 1, press Ctrl plus Alt T to pick the image. Go to the top tab, edit, transform, flip horizontally. Then press Enter. Add some effect to the image, go to layer, layer style, click drop shadow. Adjust the angle. I use 0px on size to get sharp shadow. Then click OK. Alright, now we add some text on it. On the left panel click T icon, click everywhere and type. Double click on word and arrange its size. You can also type the size you want. Still in the word, choose the font that you like at the top tab. Add some style, go to layer, layer style, click stroke. Pick the color for stroke. Add gradient overlay by click on it, click gradient color to change the color. In this case I chose red and blue. Then click OK. Try to adjust the angle. Then click OK. Now duplicate the word to make another words by copy-paste. Click on the layer of word and drag it down. Edit it, we can change the color and style, and edit the word by double-click T icon on the right panel. Do this multiple times to make another words. On layer tab, hold Ctrl then click on every layers, to get them picked together, and align them left. Now press Alt, Ctrl, T, to adjust the size of them. Then, I will add face image of my own. Add some style. Make some adjustments. The main layer need to add some saturation. Go to Image, Adjustments, Hue Saturation, then add more saturation. Don't forget to save it into PSD file. Go to File, then save as PSD. Okay, now make the build set. Create new file with transparent background. First, add the items one by one to the background, by drag and drop. Adding items is finished, select all the layer on the right to get them, and resize by change the wide on the top to 170%. Now arrange them by select each layer one by one. Put them all in the folder, by click new folder icon on the bottom right. This purpose to give style to every items by select folder layer, and go to layer, layer style. Outer glow. Put spread to 10% and size to 20px, then click OK. You can check the effect by adding color background. I duplicated the background, go to edit, fill, then OK. Add text, choose the font, and color. When it's done, hide the colored background, then crop the image by press C key on the keyboard. Save it into PNG. Now open the first project, add the build set PNG. Set the position, you can press Alt Ctrl T to resize. Enter and save the project. And last, make the emblem set. Do the same way as above. This project will become templates, if you want to make another thumbnail again later. Just do a little bit changes, and save as image. All the items I already prepared. I will share them to you, and you can find the link on the description below. This tutorial gave you some ideas to make any design related you want. I have only show you a little tool and function, there is a lot more to learn. You can try more tools like layer styles, and filters, whichever suits your like. Alright, do some positioning settings. Go to File, Export As, choose JPG, set quality to 95 to 99%, then save to download the file. It's done, guys. Thank you for watching and happy learning. Stay safe and healthy.